Very fine. Please take your seats. You notice MDG has disappeared. MDG, our motto, has to be there all the time, isn't it? We need to have our motto there. So, today we are going to talk about, learn about Islamic practitioners. Let me write that down for you. Should have today's date. Today it's the 9th. April. Holiday is coming. 2019. So our main topic is Islam, which you started some time ago. Islam, looking at these world religions, even if we are Christians, we have to some religions. But today we want to focus on the sacred practitioners. This is a subtopic for today. I'll write it in black. Sacred. Sacred practitioners. Is it visible to everyone? Can you see from there? Okay. So sacred practitioners. Right. Do we know what it means? Who knows sacred practitioners? When I say sacred practitioners, what do you think? What comes to your mind? Yeah. Sacred. When you say sacred, let's start with sacred. When you hear sacred, what do you think? So something holy. You think of bread, isn't it? And I say let's be sacred, you know, some people they start to be like this, isn't it? So this has to do with holiness. So sacred, holy. For those who may want holy. What about practitioners? In general, a practitioner is a practitioner in general. Yes?
People who do a certain activity.
So people who do a certain activity. People who practice something. Practitioner. It comes from the word practice, isn't it? So those who practice something, who do something. What else comes to your mind? Practitioners, yes?
I think it is a human being who has the ability to link the unseen and seen beings.
Who has the ability to?
Link the seen and unseen beings.
The seen and unseen beings.
That's a very interesting definition. So someone who looks like the go-between, isn't it? So here we are looking at sacred practitioners in Islam. So we are looking at people who do what? Now we are talking about Islam, a religion. Because someone who does holding in this practitioner is in the world industry. But today we are looking at sacred practitioners in Islam. Yeah.
I think sacred practitioners in Islam is based on activities or chores.
Someone who carries out activities or
rituals.
So we are talking about, this is very important, our putting point on. We're talking about people who act. I'm just putting it in the right way. Who act in the name of Islam. They perform something in the name of Islam. So they have a role. They also perform, people who perform rituals or prayers if you want. In Islam, or simply important people You understand?
Clear? Yes.
So we're going to look at certain individuals in the Islamic religion who perform certain acts in the name of the religion, or they lead rituals or prayers, or they are important, they have a certain role that they carry in this religion. Okay? I hope you've taken note of that. So, in Islam, there are so many of them. These practitioners we're talking about. There are many practitioners in Islam. So there's not only one, there are many practitioners. So today, we are going to look at four main practitioners. And I'll give you homework to research on the other four. Okay? So we're going to look at the four. And we're going to understand them, what they do, their names, or titles, their functions, and then you will go also and receive from the other four for the next class. So the first one, can I remove this or do you want it? Okay, I remove. So the first one I'm going to learn about is called Alim. Number one, this is the one I'm going to write in the Arab. Number one, Alim. Alim. Can we say Alim? Alim. Yes. That's the name of this first person I'm going to look at. The word means scholar. This one, the scholar. The word itself refers to someone who is a scholar. So this is a scholar. What is a scholar? Who is a scholar? In your general understanding, a scholar. If I say you're a scholar, are you a scholar?
Yes.
You're a scholar. Why are you a scholar? You're a student. So a student is a scholar. But someone also who is very learned in a certain area is called a scholar. So this title is given to a person who is a scholar in Arabic. So this person knows also the Quran, which is the holy book for the Muslims. You know that, right? You know, you've done that already in the previous chapters. So, an alim is a person who is learned and he knows the Quran, he knows the Arabic language, he is a scholar. So he is, in other words, he is a what? A religious. A religious authority. A religious authority in Islam, if you want to add. In Islam, religious authority, yes, power. When he stands there and people ask questions, they say, yeah, what does God say about marriage? When he speaks, all of you listen, isn't it? Someone with religious authority. When they speak, you listen. Don't worry, we'll compare with Christianity before we finish this class, because there are so many similarities. So he is also an expert, if you want, an expert. You can put expert here, a scholar, a religious authority, an expert in Islam. So this is the first person we're going to learn, an alim. So if you are a Muslim and you want to be an authority, you have to study hard and then you become an alim. So maybe we have some alims in here, I don't know. We might have some alims. So number two. Let's move on to number two. So this one I'll divide here. Number two, we have alama. The words are quite tricky. These are Arabic words. Alama. Have you ever heard of it?
No.
You've never heard of him. Alama. It's new. You myself, I didn't know you until I read about him. So this title is a title. His gift is an honorary and prestigious title in Islam. So it's a title, honorary title, or prestigious title. So I'll put here, honorary title. I hope I did. Did I get it right? Honorary. I think this is honorary title or prestigious. Question is, it's given to someone who's like what? It's carried by a very high scholar. So you see now the degrees that's going up now. This one is successful. But this one now is a very high scholar. High scholar. In Islam. You can say in Islamic law. Someone! That's it. You know, who's way up there? This one is Allah. In Islam, we've got two types of Muslims. Don't worry about this. I'm just telling you now, but you will learn this later. And in both types of Muslims, we've got the Sunni and the Shia. Both have this title. So this title is found in the Sunni Muslims, Sunni and Shia. Hey, how I got it. It's tricky, this one. Double I on Shia, double I Muslims. Don't worry, it's just the different types of Muslims that we have. Just like in Christianity, we've got Catholics and Methodists and whatnot, but all are Christians. So these ones are the two main types of Muslims. So in both, they have that title. For someone who's very high up. Okay? Clear? Any question on that one? We move on to the third one. Number three. I'm sure this one you've heard of it. Mahmoud. The Caliph. Have you heard of the Caliph? No, 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 why should I use the Caliph? If you go to those countries in the Middle East, you hear of the Caliph. The people respecting the Caliph. So that's the Caliph. Now, who is the Caliph? I'll give you a bit of background to it. This title was first used by a person called Abu Bakr. You've heard that name?
Yes.
So first used by Abu Bakr. So title first used by Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr. I got it right. Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr. Yeah, we didn't add that. That's good. First used. So who was Abu Bakr? He said, you know him. You can try, it's okay to try. What do you think? Yes.
I think he was
Prophet Muhammad's friend. Okay, that's good, that's correct. But what happened when Muhammad died? Who took over? He took over, isn't it? He was an educated head of Muslim community after the death of Muhammad. So he was the head after Muhammad. So Abu Bakr was the first head after Muhammad. So he took over from Muhammad. So educated, was an educated head of the Muslim. Prophet Muhammad. This man was the leader. Today, it's who have civil or religious leadership. So it's given to someone who is a civil leader or a religious leader. So the title is given to someone who is a title given to a civil and religious. So people like the leaders of these countries that we know, tell me the most Islamic countries that you know. You know any Islamic country?
Pakistan is proper.
Saudi Arabia. The leader is called the Caliph. Those ones who wear those things, those robes, and wear those vestments, and they move with bodyguards. So it's given to a simple and religious leader. He is a simple leader, he's like a king, but he's also a religious leader in that sense. So these ones, they are known as political successors of Muhammad, it's called them political successors of Muhammad. When these ones, when they declare war on any country, it's dangerous. Because everyone believes in them, therefore they are political muscle coming from Muhammad. Just like Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr got his strength from Muhammad. So the succession continues. There are not so many of them, but they're there in those countries. United Arab Emirates. They have the caliph, they have power. These ones. Is that clear?
Yes.
Now we go to the last one. The last one that I have for you is very common. I hope I'm ready enough. Number four here. The Imam. You know that word?
Yes.
You know? That's great. Who knows? You know the Imam? You don't know?
It's okay.
Who knows the Imam? Come on, guys, you're not friends of Muslims. Yeah, you're in a country that is 1% of its people as Muslims. The Imam. Have you seen those movies with the Imam? This one is an Islamic religious leader. Islamic religious leader. Religious. I'm getting it wrong here. He's an Islamic religious, it's supposed to be I, that's what I'm going to call it. Religious leader. There are many of them. Every community is an imam. Every Islamic community is an imam. They guide people through their religious paths. So they are like the guides. You know, they call them the guides. They are the guides. They guide people through religious paths. Guides people. He guides people through religious paths. They teach them. That one is a simple one. What do they teach?
The Quran.
The Quran. That's their job. They teach the Quran. So the Imam, he teaches the Quran. He teaches the Quran. What else do you think they do? Not that you have an idea. What else do you think they do? The Imam. Yes? They interpret the Quran as true for the people, isn't it? They interpret the Quran. What else they do? Yes?
They are counselors.
They are counselors, yes. It's something that I want you to say. They perform
rituals.
They perform rituals. Perform rituals. Religious rituals. Like what? Give me examples of the rituals that you think they do. Marriage. Isn't it? It's birth. They are the ones who do. It's death. They are the ones who lead the rituals. These people. The imams. They lead. They lead also community prayer. When they go to the mosque, you find the imam is there, he's going to lead the prayer. That's his job. What else do you think they do? They give what? Advice. They say you have a problem with your wife. It's not you, maybe. If you are a Muslim, where do you go?
To the imam.
Yes, and you say my wife is beating me. Or your wife goes to the imam and says, my husband is beating me. You see, they give advice. Gives advice. Counseling. Someone mentioned counseling there. So they offer prayers. You know, they do all these things. They interpret. Panatala interpret. They interpret. They interpret the Quran. They interpret the Quran. And Sharia. Can you see here? Oh, this is now too, you know. Do you know this word? It's Sharia. Sharia law. You don't know it? I thought you would know it. It's an important law that is known by many people. There are some countries where the Sharia law is the one which governs. It's like the law of Muhammad, the law of God. So there are about 600 laws that are called Sharia. And their job is to say, it's like us in the Catholic Church, we have the teaching of the church. You should not eat meat on Friday. That would be, if you were a Muslim, you'd say that's a Sharia law. So they have got laws and do's and don'ts. This is what they do, these people. Okay? So today we are looking at this before. Are there questions before I give you something to do? Questions are those four. Yes.
So the caliph and the imam are both religious leaders.
Yes, in a way, but this one is not a political leader. You see? This one is both religious and civil. And religious leader. Do you know when you say civil leader? Civilian, civil president, maybe president, leader of the country. But also, the country is an Islamic state. So he is also a religious leader. Yes?
How are these sacred practitioners found in both Sunni Muslim and Shia?
Sunni and Shia. Yes, you'll find them. You'll find them in both. They have these titles. I'm not sure about the other ones, which I'm going to give you as your homework to research. Yes?
So what are the duties from the Alim and the Alam?
The Alim and the Alam. These are scholars. You know a scholar? They write commentaries about, you know, so doing when you have to see you. Write commentaries. Jerome's Bible commentary. Jerome was a scholar. He would write what Jesus trying to say here. They, you know, they write things about teachings of Islam. These two. And then, but then this one is what? Is higher than this one. These are the doctors. In the Catholic Church, we say the doctors of the church. Those people who have got extreme high knowledge. So my question for you, just for the next minute or so, because we have less than 10 minutes now, is I want you to think about Christianity. And I want you to find maybe certain titles that you can put on this one. Say, ah, maybe in Christianity, this one will be this one, this one will be this one. Is it possible? Are you able to do that?
Yes.
You can discuss with your friends near you. Just 2 minutes.
Thank you.
You know, it's shower song also, if those people also nearby, near your school, somewhere down there. Yes?
A bishop.
Okay. Yeah, a bishop can be also here. But we also have what people call, I'll help you here, theologians. You know those teachers at seminar? The priests who teach theologians, they have studied and they are higher. But also bishops can also be theologians. It's okay. I think I was accepted. What about the caliph? That's why they miss the one. So the question is they need to the eight. Yeah? Yes. The Pope. That's true. Here we put the Pope. Do you know that the Pope is the head of state of the Vatican City? Holy See, the country. So the Pope is what? Is a civil leader and also a religious leader. He's like the president of the Holy See. It's a country. So the Pope is like the country. He has power. Anyone else? Maybe in other churches? Because this just happened. What about other churches or? Here you could put the Queen, I think. I think the Queen can qualify here. Do you know that the Queen of England is the leader of the Anglican Church? In a way, yes. I would put her there. The Church, the Anglican Church. What about here? Though she's not more, there's someone who does the religious leadership. What about here? The Imam. This one is a simple one. Yes. Moving on. The priest, of course. Father Kalimatia. Priest. Who else? Why are you thinking only that way? Are you all Catholics here? You don't know that there are not Catholics in here. Yes?
The pastors.
Pastors! Yes! The pastors are also here. What other people? The prophets of today. Yeah, the bishops also can be here. You know? Bishop what? Bishop Makandio, Bishop Pastor, Prophet Makandio. So this is just to help to understand Islam. When you think about your own church, you can see that it makes sense anyway. So for your homework, I want you to go and find out about these ones. I'm writing them here. They are also practitioners. Sheikh. So this is number 5. Sheikh. Number 6 would be Ayatollah. You go and research in the library. Go on the internet, you Google, you'll find Muezzin. Google is very good at telling you always who. Then lastly, it's Grand Imam. Is it clear, Sheikh? Probably you know already. Ayatollah, Muezzin, Grand Imam. So these ones, find out. Who are they? What do they do as religious practitioners? Internet helps. Google, find out, YouTube, check from other teachers, and ask them, ask if Form 6 is maybe they know already or Form 4, then you come back and you present your life. Is that fine?
Yes.
So today, in a nutshell, we looked at the separate practitioners in Islam. We identified 4, the Alim, the Alama, the Caliph, and the Imam. And we looked at their different roles, and we also had managed to look at similarities with Christianity, with those who lead, to see where we are. So now we can understand Muslims. If you see a Muslim, you can ask, are you an Imam, or you are a Caliph, or you are what, you know? They will be happy. Is that okay?
Yes.
Good. So we will see you next time when we come again. And I will expect you to give me your presentations on the 4.
Everyone has to come up with something. A short write-up on the Sheikh, Ayatollah, Muezzin, and Grand Imam. All right, thank you. It's time. Class is over.